सब्सक्राइब करें, प्रेस करें बेल आइकॉन और पाए मुंबई, नवी मुंबई एवं बॉलीवुड की ताजा तरीन खबरें।
With an aim to strengthen the Indo-Norway relations and combat serious problems of climate change and environmental pollution, Norway's Minister of International Development, Dagging Ulstein, visited India and participated in the Mithi River cleanup drive with renowned environmental activist Afroz Shah. Afroz Shah, an environmental activist and the man behind conducting the world's largest beach cleanup drive, miraculously cleaned the Warsowa beach, has now shifted its focus and is now on an unstoppable mission to clean the Mithi River. Dagging Ulstein, who was on a three-day tour to India, also met Maharashtra's Tourism and Environment Minister Aditya Thackeray and shared Norway's agenda of sustainable development while showing concern and sharing solutions for cities' plastic waste management. He visited the banks of Mithi River in order to understand the areas which need concern and discuss cooperation between the two countries while sharing Norway's experience in waste management and a plan of action in tackling environment issues. The Mithi, flowing through the heart of Mumbai, is India's oldest river system, which meets the Arabian Sea at Mahim Creek, starts at the Vihar and Pavai lakes, and passes through several areas of the city's suburbs, which today is reeked and ravaged in waste and garbage, transforming itself into a narrow sewage. Over decades, the Mithi River has been abused and polluted. There are around 1,000 industrial units along the river, out of which most of them discharge their waste and pollutants into the water body, leaving a patch of the river covered in water hyacinth, plastic, silt and other waste. The residents of slums adjacent to the Mithi River face serious problems of stagnation, with mosquitoes breeding on the water body and spreading the fear of deadly diseases. The Mithi becomes apathetic when flooded during monsoons, leaving Mumbaikers in knee-deep toxic waste.
Mithi Nadi ka pani to aisa filhal jab barish hoti hai to tabhi problem hota hai, jaise ki jab dam matlab over ho jata hai pani to upar se pura pani jab aata hai to hamare pure area mein pani aa jata hai aur sare gharon mein pani ghus jata hai aur sabke ghar mein matlab kafi saman nuksan hota hai aur yahan tak ki ghar se pura totally saman nikal gaye दूसरे जगह शिफ्टिंग भी होना पड़ता है। मेन प्रॉब्लम क्या है, जब पानी जो भरता है अंदर एरिया में जो आता है उसका सोल्यूशन ढूंढना चाहिए। वो जब प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व होगा तो फिर ये सब प्रॉब्लम ही नहीं होगा। अगर हम लोग कुछ ऐसा करें जिससे कचरा ही ना हो तो ये प्रॉब्लम भी खत्म हो जाएगा ना।
विद नॉर्वे सेटिंग बेंचमार्क विद इट्स मेथड्स ऑफ वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट एंड एफिशिएंट स्टॉर्म वाटर ड्रेनेज सिस्टम, they have now extended their support in the Mithi River cleanup project to develop a more holistic approach to the rising problems of plastic disposal. Alongside, Norway's Minister Ulstein and environmentalist Afroz Shah participated in the cleanup initiative along with city's other environmentalists and local residents residing near the river. The minister sat down along with his team and jointly addressed the students and residents who came to offer their help and support to this initiative and educated and spread awareness on the same. The children went on to pick and collect garbage across the slums adjoining the Mithi River. Speaking to NMTV, Norway's International Development Minister Dagging Ulstein shared the purpose of his visit and his agenda of sustainable development and the goals to be achieved.
You know, it's a global challenge, and the ocean, the water is connecting us. So it's actually, we have some of the same problems, especially when it comes to ocean and the fish that are actually eating some of these microplastics. And also you probably heard about the whales that have so much plastic. And we're destroying our nature, and that is our future. It's food, it's energy, it's jobs. So then we need to learn and connect this with education at school. And for us, we will stand together with Afroz and others that will continue to work on this. So the Norwegian government has been engaged in marine litter, and to create more sustainable management around oceans is really important for us. And then we need to make sure that the plastic won't get up in the oceans in the first hand.
He went on to praise the efforts of environmentalist Afroz Shah, his team, and the young minds of the city who took up the responsibility of making Mithi a healthy flowing river again, and called out for more such ambassadors of nature to join this important work.
I think what we see right here, and what Afroz and the other, especially the young people, are doing, is such an important lesson for all of us. And to see young people standing up and really want to take care of Mother Nature and to create a better world for the next generation. And then we need to handle plastic and the litter and the garbage in a total other way. That's the same back in home in Norway, and that's the same here. So it's really inspiring to see the important work of Afroz and others here. And especially the young people. It's a new mindset. The change has come. So that's really good to see. I just want to say what we see also back home is that in handling waste and to take care of waste in another way, that creates value, that creates jobs, and that creates opportunities. So I think it's so important to have the mindset in place and to understand the connection with nature. And it's our responsibility, as you say. And I think you're leading by such a good example of it. And to modulate that to the young people, and to see the coming up a lot of ambassadors for the nature and for these important works.
Calling it a mission to rejuvenate the Mithi River, environmentalist Afroz Shah, speaking to NMTV, educated us about their mission, the aim of changing mindsets, creating a sense of belonging, and shared the positive responses they've been receiving from the masses around.
We call it not cleanup, but rejuvenation. Rejuvenation is a far wider term. Mm. It means cleanup, it means no littering, it means reduction of garbage. Yeah. Now, Mithi River, I'll tell you, when it got flooded long back, 2005-06, from then onward, there are various government committees being formed. All these committees had only three things to say: solid waste, liquid waste, and mindset. Liquid waste, of course, the government will to handle. Now, the minister is going to meet Aditya Thackeray also, the Honorable Minister for Environment, and my dear friend. So they will have a conversation how to handle the liquid waste. What we are doing now here is handling the solid waste. And waste is a socio-economic problem. So it's not about tender. It's not about saying that, oh, so many workers will go. It's about changing mindset of the people. Mm-hmm. So solid waste, liquid, and mindset. So we are working on solid waste and mindset for 15 months. This 35,000 population, 80% are segregating as of now, so which is a good sign. We will move ahead. 1.25 kilometer is clean, no littering. 18 kilometers, maybe next 5 years.
That's the goal. That's wonderful.
Yeah.
What do the slum and the people who live here have to say about this rejuvenation which are doing for the Mithi River?
They love it. Mm. You know, I will quote you. A mosque is here at the corner, and the imam of that mosque told me when I came the first time. I said, was Mithi like this ever? He said, no, we used to do wadu. That's called ablution in essence. Yeah. So he used to wash his hands like. So I said, what happened? It has turned into a sewer. And this is not because of a bad law or a bad implementation. It's about what I call in English, loss of sense of belonging. We have lost the sense of belonging to our planet, to our lake, to our river. So the idea is not only to clean, not only to train people, but to get them the feeling that this is my river. This is where I live. It must be clean. I must go for a swim. I should get the water out from there. Mm. Let's see. It's a long journey. Hopefully, it gets solved during our lifetime.
The Indo-Norway cooperation to being connected to the waters in regards to the preservation of marine life and to tackle marine debris, Afroz Shah and the Norwegian government aims to promote and spread awareness regarding garbage disposal to establish healthy mindsets to treat Mother Nature. Bureau Report, NMTV News.